The body of Christ, the living bread descended from heaven, means to immerse oneself deeply in the mystery of Christ, that becomes bread to give himself to all who wish to take part, to become one with Christ, and become in completion as he is. Joining Christ is living in communion with his heart. In this land of love, the Father has given us a part of himself, so that everyone could be satiated and watered. Take and eat, all of you, drink, to refresh the heart, the spirit, and return to being pure like children, white like doves and strong as true Christians fighting to win, to defend and proclaim the truth to all. Here the Father has re-established his church, one, holy and universal, because the bread that descended from heaven could never be mixed with all that the world offers, with other breads that have nothing of divine, of holy, of pure, of essential and substantial. Here, in his white island, the Father wants to preserve the purity of authentic faith in Christ, which cannot be mixed with other so-called religious philosophies that have nothing to do with the authenticity of the Christian faith. Who mixes the living bread descended from heaven with that which does not come from heaven, changes the authenticity of the living bread descended from heaven. It changes the fragrance, the genuineness, it changes its essence and thus its substance. This is what happened in another house, which contaminated that bread with all that is world, making the original bread lose its peculiar characteristic. To be essential and substantial nourishment for all the children of God, who, because of this, were deprived in that house of living nourishment that the Father, through Christ, had given them. Who makes believe of wanting to nourish the children of God, but actually discarded Christ, selling off Christ to mix him with other so-called religious philosophies that do not recognize him as the Son of the living God, deceive the children of God, in full awareness of what is done. Not a mistake, not an error, but a living awareness of the project that is being carried out. And this makes the difference with what has happened in the history of Christianity, where so many, it's true, they made mistakes, even those, Peter's successors, who should not have. But here we are in the presence of something different. Not a mistake of a few, but a clear project that undermines the foundations of Christianity with awareness. This is the difference, which is essential and substantial, and which determined the intervention of the Father in history. This is why the Father in his omnipotence in this land of love has restored his church, refounding it, in order not to make the children of God lack the essential and substantial nourishment that is Christ, the living bread descended from heaven. Feed yourselves. Quench. Taste his fragrance. Taste his essence. Taste, to be fused in him and become a single amalgam that bears fruit in abundance. From the tree we recognize the fruits, and from the fruits the truth is recognized. If the tree is good, the fruits are good. If the bread is uncontaminated, the fruits are candid. In order to satisfy the demand of all those who come here in search of the bread, the only bread, that is way, truth and life. In this land of love the Mass is lived. Here we are and we live the communion with the Father. Being in communion with the Father means doing his will, respecting his commandments and living his authentic teachings that in Christ are manifested.